Here goes downstairs. Oh, Raj is taking it right from the start. Nice going, Raj. Well, you taping. Say hi. Go ahead, Jen. Are you going with the door? Come on, walk down. Come on. Raj is taking it full length right from the beginning, leaving the house. You okay? Nice trip. Diane, you want to come in our car? You might as well.
No, I'm
going
with the
Jessica. Oh, you're going to take Roger and Diane in the car?
It's
Jess, come here. You should have got a jacket for this kid. It's not that cold. Come on, Jess. Oh, no, she gets shy.
I know.
Jen, Mike, anyway.
Do a little tap dance for us.
Ow. Okay, Jen, you have to go downstairs, right?
Wave goodbye, Jennifer.
Wave goodbye to Uncle Roger.
What are you hiding behind me?
I'm not.
Jennifer, go downstairs. You have to go in through the church, go downstairs. We'll see you in church.
Bye, Jennifer.
How's that dress? Looks nice on it. Still videotaping us? Get more of my daughter. Her day.
No, not this one.
Yeah, either one, doesn't matter.
You gonna wait outside? You gonna go in?
We can wait a few minutes. Hi, how are you?
Thank you.
morning, everyone. This is a truly exciting day. I think all of us are a lot excited, a little bit nervous perhaps, and it's a day to really glorify the Lord for the gifts that He has given us. And so I invite you to join with me in prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord be with you. It was several years ago that you parents presented your sons and daughters to the church for the very first time in the sacrament of baptism. Through water and through the Holy Spirit, they were brought into Christ's church. And now you present them again as they make another step in their initiation into the church. You present them for First Eucharist. And so as we begin our celebration this morning, we remember back to the first time that you presented them here in the church. We remember back to their baptism. We bless holy water that reminds us of that baptism, and I will walk among you, sprinkling you with holy water, reminding each one of us that truly we are sons and daughters of the Lord through baptism. God our Father, your gift of water brings life and freshness to the earth. It washes away our sins and brings us eternal life. We now ask you to bless this water and to give us your protection on this day that you have truly made your own. Renew the living spring of your life within us, and protect us in spirit and body, that we may be free of sin and come into your presence to receive your gift of salvation. We ask you this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Supper, he took the cup and said, "This cup is God's new covenant, sealed with my blood. Whenever you drink it, do it in memory of me." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This is such a very special day, not only in your life as a family, but also in our life as the family of Christ the King, to be here gathered together on the first Saturday of May to celebrate this communion. And before I say a few words to those who are celebrating their first communion, our young men and women, I'd like to say a few words to their parents. Now that the process of the year is finished, I think you look back and you say to yourself, I never knew there was going to be that much involved with it. The meetings that you attended, the things that you learned, all very, very important. And I think that just as parents very often find themselves going every day, all day, as perhaps chauffeurs going here and there or going to different occasions with their children, they attend these things because their very presence at them shows your children that you love them, that you care for them. Your very presence at the penance meetings and at the First Communion meetings showed your children that you love them, that you care for them, and even more than that, that this is very important to you. And we ask you to keep that in mind for the future, to maintain that aura that you have with them now, that this is something very, very important to you. I'd like to thank you an awful lot for your cooperation during the past year, because your cooperation meant an awful lot, not only to Miss Madden, but also to all of us, and it meant an awful lot to your children. To the boys and girls who are here today, gee, you look nice. You really do. All the girls all dressed in their First Communion outfits and their veils, and the boys looking so wonderfully handsome in their suits. And I think parents and grandparents who are here, and aunts and uncles, are kind of busting their buttons, you might say, filled with pride that their sons and daughters look so nice and they are able to share with them such a very, very beautiful day. And you know, there's something about today. There's a lot of finery, and probably for many of you later down this morning or maybe this afternoon, there are parties, there might be gifts. And I think it's very human in all of this, maybe to get sidetracked and miss the point of why we're here. So I'd like to focus on that very literally today. We are here because of the Lord Jesus. And as your children can tell you who went through their learning about First Communion all during this year, we are here for bread and for wine that are going to be changed into the body and the blood of the Lord Jesus. And as I say, we're going to focus on that. I meant it literally, because here they are. And this is the focus of our celebration. All the other things are very nice, very important, and they're fun. But this is really the focus of where it's at. And as your children can tell you, all this is right now is bread. All this is right now is wine. And even the gifts that will be brought forward in a few moments, they are simply bread and wine, nothing more. And in a complex world that we live in, isn't it amazing that Jesus took something so simple, so available, and gave us himself through this? Just like in the first sacrament we received, what could be simpler than the element of water? The simplest things on our earth, the Lord uses to call us to salvation. For one brief shining moment in the history of mankind, Jesus Christ walked this earth for only 33 years. And during that moment, he taught us how important it is to love one another. He taught us how important it is to be kind and good to one another. He taught us how much God really loves us. God had never walked the face of the earth before, and God will never walk the face of the earth again. But in that one brief moment, Jesus changed our history. Our history as a planet, and our history as individuals. We're gathered here to celebrate his memory. Because that's what we do when we share bread and wine. We are saying to ourselves and to all around us that there was someone whom we loved, And he asked us to come together. And he asked us to remember him because of the things that he did, because of the things that he taught, and because of the way those things have shaped and molded and changed our lives. And he said to us, when you come together to remember me, I will not be only a distant memory. I will be there with you. Because when you say the same words that I said at the Last Supper, this bread and this wine will be changed, and I will be with you again when you assemble to remember me. That is what makes us who we are as a people. Simplest things in the world, bread and wine. And yet they make us who we are, and each time we gather together as God's family, we share this very, very simple meal. And this morning, after the words that Jesus used are repeated over the simple bread and wine, they truly become the body and blood of Jesus. And Jesus is truly present among us. And we do something then that is even more beautiful. We share him with one another so that we are one not only with the Lord, but we are one with one another. This is the gift that God has given to us. This is the gift that you boys and girls share for the very first time today. And this is the gift that Jesus offers you to share every time that you come to remember him and celebrate him here at Mass. Simple things. And yet really isn't that what life is all about? The simplest of things are the things that really make us happy. The simplest of things are the things that really nourish us. And so the Lord gives us a very simple thing, bread and wine. Asks us to come together. Remember me, because I love you, and you love me. I have changed your life so you'll never be the same again. And I want to nourish you so that you can continue to be a disciple. And so I give you the greatest gift that anyone could ever give another person. Not a thing, not a present, not a picture, not a memory. I give you the greatest gift of all. I give you myself. I invite you to stand as we offer our prayers and our petitions to the Lord. Heavenly Father, with joy we gather in your presence to celebrate your love. May we always be grateful for your faithful care and for your many blessings to us. We ask you this in Christ, our Lord. Response this morning will be, Lord, bless your people.
Our response is, Lord, bless your people.
Lord, bless your people.
For Pope John Paul and all bishops who touch people throughout the world with the vision of God's love, we pray.
Lord, bless your people.
For all people
have called us together in one family and have adopted us as your own. Hear our prayers this morning for those we love. Bless us, guide us, and nourish us. We ask you this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Acknowledge that you are holy, and that you are kind to us and to all people. thank you above all for your Son, Jesus Christ. He brought us the good news of life to be lived with you forever in heaven. He showed us the way to that life, the way of love. He himself has gone that way before us. He now brings us together to one table and asks us to do what he did. Father, we ask you to bless these gifts of bread and wine and make them holy. Change them for us into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, your Son. On the night before he died for us, he had supper for the last time with his disciples. He took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to his friends, saying, take this, all of you, and eat. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In the same way, he took a cup of water. He gave you thanks and handed the cup to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Then he said to them, do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim this mystery of faith.
Gladness of Easter, help us to bring this joy.
share in this supper.
Lord, I am my Lord, please receive you. And also say the word, and I shall be healed.
Thank you.
say to us, so we can get your book about it. And we're going to say this prayer together. It's the prayer after communion. Everybody ready? Okay? Dear Jesus, thank you for loving me so much. Thank you for the gift of your body and blood in Holy Communion. This is such a special day, and I feel so happy. Jesus, please bless all of the people in my family and all of the people in our parish family. Most of all, please bless my mommy and dad. Thank you for giving me such wonderful parents who love me so much. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. That was very beautiful. Of course, it's a very nice evening to give thanks to all the people who worked so hard for this very special day. I'd like to thank our organist and our choir over there, who are made up of brothers and sisters of those who made their first communion. We didn't have enough room on the altar for everybody to be an altar boy or girl, so we had a choir composed of brothers and sisters of those who made their first communion. I'd like to also thank all of those teachers who worked so hard all the way through the parent meetings and also during the practices, and the head of our CCD over on Tuesday, Mrs. Mann. But most importantly, I'd like to thank the team. I'd like to thank Mrs. Madden. This is our first opportunity to thank her publicly. And for you parents who went to the meetings, I think you realize what a gift we have in Mrs. Madden. And we're certainly happy the day she walked in our door, and we hope that she stays with us a very, very long time. She's a most lovely lady, and if you think that your son or daughter was excited about today, you should have been on the rectory all week. Boy, I don't know if you slept last night. I'm sure she did. But she puts everything in there. And speaking for the team who is here, we'd like to congratulate your sons and daughters and all of you who have a son or daughter or a grandson or daughter who made First Communion today. And we'd like to invite you immediately following the Mass to join us downstairs in the church hall for a little refreshment, a little bit of time to see our friends and neighbors, and to offer congratulations to everyone. Please stand. Loving God, you share with us your life and your love through Jesus, who is the bread of life. Help us now to share your love with one another. We ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us all go forth in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
want to find out if he wants me to carry the tripod.